Today, I want to talk about sugar. Did you know that American adults on average consume staggering 60 pounds or 27 kilograms of added sugar annually? We all know that it's bad for us, but gosh, donuts, cakes, chocolates, aren't they delicious? Sure they are, but we all know that we'll pay for eating all these goodies with our waistlines and bad teeth. But how many of you have considered links between high sugar intake and things like pancreatic cancer, the deadliest and most painful cancer? Yes, sugar can do that. But we don't have to be so dramatic. How about issues like worsening memory, Alzheimer's, or just simple muscle and joint pains that simply don't go away? Believe it or not, but all of these have been linked to high sugar diet. Now, I could talk about a damaging effect of sugar on mitochondria and the fact that eating all this sugar is robbing our body of all these vitamins and minerals that our body needs to process the ton of sugar we eat. But that topic has been way exhausted already. Instead, I want to discuss several conditions that either already affects millions of people or terrifies the rest of them just thinking about them. So let's start with the first one, and that's the effect of high sugar diet on brain function and our memory. Our brain needs sugar because that's its primary fuel, but consistently elevated level of blood sugar damages our brain. Believe it or not, but it actually shrinks your brain. The hippocampus, which is a region of the brain that plays a critical role in memory formation and consolidation, gets hammered with high sugar diets. Some researchers believe that the oxidative damage to the brain cells is the main culprit, while others are pointing out to the inflammation, which is triggered by the damage to the brain cells from the high sugar in the blood. But regardless of the mechanism, the damage is happening. Now let's talk about insulin resistance, because it's important to understand what sugar does to our brains. Do you know that by the time someone starts showing the first symptoms of type 2 diabetes, more than 50% of the beta cells that make insulin inside the pancreas are pretty much gone? Yep, they're gone. And that reflects the fact that majority of people who are running around with insulin resistance don't even know it. So what does it have to do with sugar and the brain? When someone develops insulin resistance, their body loses ability to use the insulin effectively. That's important because our brain also uses insulin to help regulate all the signaling mechanisms, which are crucial for memory and learning. So when we have high level of blood sugar and develop insulin resistance, our bodies don't respond well to insulin. That will pretty much mess up how our brain remembers things. We also need to think about how too much sugar can hurt the blood vessel and arteries in our brain. When our blood sugar is high all the time, it can make these blood vessels stiffer and narrower. This changes how blood moves through the brain. If not enough blood gets to the brain, it doesn't get oxygen and nutrients that it needs. Over time, this can make the brain function much less effectively. That's right, while we feast on the sugary goodies, our brains are starving because all that I just said is causing structural and functional changes in the brain, which affects our ability to consolidate and retrieve memory. Now, don't think that this affects only old population. High sugar diet also affects learning. And this was demonstrated in a study done at UCLA, where the authors pretty much summarized their findings by saying that college students who tend to binge on high sugary snacks are actually becoming stupid. I mean, literally. Now, I want to point out that when we talk about high sugar diets, we are particularly talking about high fructose corn syrup, which is used as the main sweetener in most processed foods. We are not talking about the fructose that naturally occurs in fresh fruits. Now take a guess at what devastating condition primarily manifests as a problem with memory and learning new things. If you said Alzheimer's, you're absolutely right. Besides all that I just said, high sugar diet also leads to inflammation that damages the brain cells and contributes to the accumulation of harmful proteins in the brain, such as beta amyloids, which is seen in Alzheimer's disease. But let's talk about a little bit less depressing effect of sugar. Well, not really. since depression and mental disorders are another detrimental effect of high sugar diet. I mean, let's be honest. How many of you have been feeling great after a few days of being on a sugar binge? Maybe some of you temporarily, but for the most individuals, high sugar intake leads to low levels of what's called brain-derived neutrophilic factors, BDNF. Now, without going into too much details, the BDNF supports the survival and growth of existing neurons and encourages the formation of new connections called synapses between neurons. It also helps to prevent shrinkage of the hippocampus, which, as we already mentioned, is a part of the brain that's important for memory. So when BDNF levels are low because we are binging on sugary foods, neurons don't function as well as they should, and this can contribute to depression. Now let's talk about aging. We all want to look at our best. I mean, who doesn't? But believe it or not, eating too much sugary foods increases the rate of biological aging. This is particularly due to the formation of so-called advanced glycation end products, AGEs. These molecules build up in the human cells and are linked to aging. AGEs forms when sugars such as glucose or fructose link with amino acids, which are building blocks of protein. When AGEs link with collagen and elastins, both of which support the skin, it makes the skin look dry, saggy, and wrinkled. Diet is a major source of AGEs, and the accumulation of AGEs is considered an inevitable component of the aging process. So the more sugar you eat, the more AGEs you accumulate, and the quicker you will age. AGEs are also linked to several chronic diseases, including diabetes, cardiovascular diseases, kidney disease, and as I mentioned, Alzheimer's disease. These diseases contribute to oxidative damage in the body, which damages the cells throughout the body and in turn accelerates aging process. Now let's talk about telomeres. This is actually a very active area of research. Telomeres are protective caps at the end of chromosomes. Every time cells divide, the telomeres get shorter. When they get too short, the cell can no longer divide and becomes senescent, which is a fancy term for saying that the cell is either no longer fully functioning or dies. This process is associated with aging, cancers, and higher risk of death. High sugar intake has been associated with shorter telomeres, which suggests that high sugar diet could accelerate aging at the cellular level. Now, what about the gut microbiota? Quite a bit of research suggests that the high sugar diet has pretty negative impact on the gut microbiota, which is the community of the microorganisms that lives in the human gut. Now, changes in the gut microbiota have been associated with a number of health problems, including obesity, diabetes, and heart disease. One of the things that high sugar intake does to our guts is that it can reduce the function of the gut barrier, which means that the integrity of the gut barrier is compromised. This allows the substances that should stay inside of the gut to cross into the bloodstream. Pretty nasty stuff if you think about this. This phenomenon is also called a leaky gut syndrome. The consequence of this can be systemic inflammation, which is associated with many age-related diseases. Now check this out. Did you know that the majority of our immune system is situated in our guts? Yep, that's right. The gut microbiota is essential for proper immune function, and high sugar diets can affect this. This can lead to increased risk of infections and diseases, which can again accelerate aging. Now, many people wonder how much sugar is considered excessive. In my opinion, this is a highly debated topic. However, I can provide you with some guidelines based on common sense and practicality, meaning recommendations that are realistic for average person to follow. So when it comes to taking care of our health, I truly believe that we should steer away from consuming any added sugar on a regular basis. Let me say it again, on a regular basis. Of course, it's a human nature to indulge in some comfort food, especially during holidays and special occasions. as long as we don't make it an everyday habit. That means saying no to daily sodas, juices, candies, chocolates, donuts, and all those sugar-loaded goodies. Have you ever looked at their labels? They're not just packed with sugar, but loaded with all sorts of other junk. Trust me, you don't need it. Now, I understand that completely cutting out all the added sugar might be a challenge for some folks. In such cases, the American Heart Association has set up some guidelines for sugar intake. According to their recommendations, men should aim for no more than 36 grams or 9 teaspoons of added sugar per day, while women should aim for no more than 25 grams or 6 teaspoons of sugar a day. And for the little ones, the recommendation is generally based on age and calorie needs, but generally it should stay under 25 grams or 6 teaspoons per day. Going over these limits is generally considered too much sugar. But remember, these guidelines are specifically about added sugar, the ones that don't naturally occur in foods. The sugars found in fruits, vegetables, and dairy products are perfectly fine as part of a healthy diet. Now, I've heard some people count regular carbohydrates from foods like breads, fruits, and pasta as sugars too. Personally, I don't quite see it that way. As long as we enjoy these foods in a sensible portion, we should be fine. The real issue is that many folks struggle with portion control, not knowing how much of these carbs-containing food they should eat to stay within the healthy range. But hey, that's a whole another topic to dive into. Oh, and if you want some tips on how to help your body regulate blood sugar, especially after meals, I've got a video down below, so you may want to check it out. Remember, take care of your health, make smart food choices, and I will catch you in the next video.